We'll go straight into speaking English. I gather there are some non-Icelanders in the audience, and for sure to be able to speak to our wonderful artist, Ange Legia, whom we are more than happy to, we are actually thrilled to be able to present his work here at the National Gallery. Work that you see in the background of our talk today, titled La Mer, Hafið in Icelandic. My name is Birta Guðjónsdóttir. I'm head of exhibitions at the National Gallery. Happy to introduce to you the artist Ange Legia and the curator of this exhibition, Æsa Sigurjónsdóttir. They will have a discussion about the work, about the artistic interventions of Ange, and we will then have a chance to discuss a little bit after their talk. We have lowered the sound of this video and sound installation at the occasion of the talk, just for you to know, for those who have not seen the installation from the opening day on Thursday until today. And I urge you all to just feel very welcomed and very comfortable to stay in this room and in the installation. And I would like to give the word to Æsa, and as well my thanks on behalf of the National Gallery of Iceland. Many thanks to both of you for a great collaboration. We are very proud of the exhibition. Takk fyrir.
Thank you. Thank you, Birta. Well, please, Ange.
Thank you, Birta.
I will just have start with a very short introduction about you, Ange Legia. You were born in Corsica in 1952. And you started making art very, very early on, I think already as a teenager. You were a student in a experimental lycée or in an experimental high school, and you have talked about that in interviews before, that how this kind of education inspired you. How your professors encouraged you and many others to start experimenting. And I think, in fact, there are several artists who came out of this graduation program. Then you went up to Paris, like we say in France. You went to the capital, because Corsica is quite far away, in fact, in the south. And you started your studies in La Sorbonne. You started also very early to exhibit, and I think you had your first solo show in 1985 in Musée de l'Art Moderne, at the Contemporary Art Section. And the first time you were exhibiting in a kind of a big international show was in 1987 in Documenta in Kassel. I'm right, I think so. Maybe you could just shortly tell us how it came about that you got sort of into this video art so early. And I think I can say that you are a pioneer in video art in the French context.
Your question is very, very long. Yes, when I am young, I am very interested about cinema. I am more interested from cinema than the art scene. I was more impressed when I saw Zapriskie Point from Antonioni, or Theorem from Pasolini, or some Godard films as Pierrot le Fou, as Le Mépris. I don't know, you translate méprise the attempts, the...
Well, this, I think it's discussed.
It's Godard, yes, it's discussed. The nouvelle vague, new wave movie French group. Then, donc I was more impressed by cinema than art scene. I don't like for me canvas, peinture is it was something of very common, and for me from a small island, from a small place, from a village, to be in contact with camera, with films, it was more exciting for me when I grew up. And I take this habitude to think, to develop art with movie camera and after video. But my attitude, my point of view is, I think, very, very near as a painter, painting.
Painter.
Yeah, as a painter. I don't know, you see this work, La Mer is very close to this idea to have a look, to stay with only a point of view.
Yes, you started working on La Mer already in the late 80s, or this is a work that you are kind of constantly working on, you are constantly readapting it to different situations, to different spaces. And I think that's the second point I would like to ask you about, is that how you work with space, because in fact you make video art, but this your video art is installation at the same time.
Yes.
And your thought about the space, and you have also made a lot of installation works. Unfortunately, we were not it was not possible to bring in your installation works here. But just to let the audience know that you are not only a video artist, you also work a lot with objects. And the space is important for you, and the structure, how you structure the space, how you use the image in the space, etc. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about, for example, how this the importance of space for your work and in your work.
Yes, I am an artist, and only critics put me in video section or installation section. When I grow up, I make films, but also with movie vocabulary, with projectors, with a lot of things about cinema. I did objects installation near the spirit of the ready-made, and often at the beginning there is two sort of critics. Or curators, they invite me or in video exhibition or in objects exhibition, and each time I try to put them together, and it was very, very difficult. But when I am the curator of my show, when it's possible to have a big space, different rooms, I build my exhibition in this way, but because there is some connection between some objects and some film. To answer about the space, I think that my first space is my mind, is my studio, is my spirit, is my introspective attitude. And after, I bring, I put, I send my work for the audience, but I need to adapt my way to exhibit in confrontation of the architecture or the country where I am. I think I don't do the same show when I am in Cambodia or when I am in Iceland. And also I like to be open of the energy of the sensitive place where I exhibit sometimes, and also in some country I try before to spend times to more understand where I am and how to build in the better way my exhibition when it's possible.
You also mentioned the other day that, for example, when you use cinematic material, when you use cinema use it as a ready-made, and when you use the pop song, you also see them as a ready-made. And for the audience who have not seen the video, I hope you will stay a little bit longer so you can see the whole video, which lasts almost an hour. And I think your use of the music and the use of the reference to like famous cinema moments is quite particular. So maybe there is a relationship there with your installation work and with the filmed image that you could tell us a little bit more about.
Yes. Sorry, my English is difficult. My life, me, I am not behind walls. Sometimes I am in front of the sea, sometimes I am in a bar or in a restaurant, there is music. Sometimes I am in a movie theater, sometimes I am in the street, and each time in each situation, I am me, I am a sensitive artist, and perhaps when I am in front of the sea, I have the idea of a work, but perhaps also when I am in a taxi and listening music of the taxi, this music gives to me an idea to make artwork, because we are in the real life. Artist is not close in a special jail, artistic jail. No, we are we make part of the real life, and sometimes, yes, I use parts of pop song or pop life, and became part, or I mixed to be an artwork. J'ai bien répondu ou pas?
So you think the digitalization of culture has helped you with this kind of remix techniques that you are developing?
That I develop is art or artistic scene when we are alone, when we are close in himself, I think for me is negative. Art needs, I don't know, satellites to oxygen my practice. I like dance, I like opera dancer, I like architecture, I like movie, and all these satellites close. Very close as architecture or music, very close of art, give oxygen of my practice. And Yes, my practice is to be very open, to look at the around me, to listening music, looking at other art form, and also perhaps some scientific progress, project interests a lot me.
Yeah, this brings us also to the importance of traveling in your work.
Yes, the importance of traveling is there is several traveling. The first traveling is to put out. There is some artist in the audience here. The first travel is to put the work outside of the atelier of my room, because art exists if somebody look at. If I read a book and nobody reads the book non-exist. If I read the music and if nobody listens this music, the music non-exist. And traveling is to be in contact with other people, to make exchange, and also to learn. We have this work, La Mer, the sea, is I shoot this work in Corsica, is the beach where I grow up. It's very close to the window of my home, and look at the sun. And I did this work when I am old. I am 41 or 40. After a long stay in Japan, and in Japan, Shinto civilization, Shinto culture is very close to the nature, and some friends bring me on Sunday, on holidays, walking in the mountains, looking at the big wave on the beach, on cascade, je sais pas comment tu dis les cascades.
Waterfall.
Oh, yeah, yes, waterfall. Yes. And they teach to me the importance of the nature as a god, as a philosophic way. And when I come back after this trip in Corsica, I saw my home completely different, and I did this work with the sea. If I never go in Japan, I don't make this work. And a lot of time, foreigner country helped me to know me better. Je bois un peu d'eau.
So in fact, it was the traveling to this Japanese culture and this way of observing nature in Japan, this kind of very philosophical way they have of observing nature, that made you see your own landscape in a totally new way.
Yes, because also is a Zen work, is a work about times, is as a clock, and also the waves are all the time the same, but never the same. And I like this idea. You ask to me if I did this work often. For me, it's all the time the same work as the same wave. But I did each 2-3 years. It depends of the if when I am in Corsica there is a big storm. I make this work. And also, from 91, the technology changed. The first video, if I show to you, the first video is completely no focus. I don't know.
Totally analog image.
Yes. and the quality, the technical quality change each 2, 3, 4 years, and I like also this.
Yes, because here we see that the high definition of the image becomes like a very, very important texture of the image.
Yes, the texture is important. Also, the quality of the day. I shoot some sea, some la mer. It was a big storm, raining. Sometimes it's cloudy. And as our life, each time there is a all change is never the same with her.
So, in fact, this kind of Oriental philosophy is quite important for you. This way of observing time and repetition and.
Yes, often because the repetition. When I built this work for you, for this, for the National Gallery, I use the sea as a mirror to reflect some scene, and each 2 minutes, another a different scene arrive. As if you are dreaming in front of the sea. And you see, sometimes another situation arrive. It for me is yes, contemplation. If I am just in front of a mountains, I don't think about the mountains all the time. Perhaps I think other things, to my work, I don't know, to my family, to my sadness.
Yes, then I think this brings us to another aspect that has become very important in contemporary art, is like memory and time. And even though there is kind of a timelessness in your work, you are not really referring to any period of time, and the time seemed to be kind of the thread or the fil conducteur, like you would say in French, the.
I think to understand something, to well understand something, we need approach. We need to turn around. We need look again and again. I don't know. Cézanne paint 172 Montagne Sainte Victoire. I think you need times, and each Montagne Sainte Victoire is different.
Yes, Montagne Sainte Victoire is the mountain that Cézanne was painting again and again.
And I think an artist do the same thing all his life. I think we have one idea between 12 and 20. And after, we do all the time the same. And sure, the life changes some parts of our work, but I think it's the same way to think, to make art, to build. We are very repetitive artists, person.
And tell me, your stay in Iceland, has it had some given you some ideas or influenced you somehow?
I am from Corsica. It's a very small island, and Iceland is a very large island. I have a frustration.
Frustration.
Frustration, yes. to stay only here. In the city, I won't come back to travel. I saw pictures, I saw movie of Iceland, and it's very great. It's, I won't come back to walk, to cross the landscape. think is my next project.
So kind of a land art project then, or?
Just to feel, to understand, to look at the nature, and perhaps yes. 2-3 years after, to have an idea to make a work.
So in fact, there's this need to be in like a perpetual movement and.
Yes, but that I say is very important. Sometimes I travel in Middle East. I take a lot of pictures of films, but I start to edit perhaps 5-6 years after. I edit, I think it's a part of the year. I take some image, I don't know, 25 years ago, and I found only just now the how to edit. Mm-hmm. I need times, and I like this rumination. I don't know.
This?
Ruminé.
Yes. This kind of ruminé, in Icelandic, it's eins og dýrin gera, það sem þetta jórtra, það sem þetta melta. You need this time to kind of have this old material that you've taken many, many years ago, sometimes decades ago, and maybe you dig it out 25 years later, and then finally you know how to use it, or then it's saying something to you that you never seen before.
And yes, and also some situation that I build and that I saw 20 years ago, the meaning changed, and today it's possible to make with them to build other ideas. And I like this. I don't answer to you when you say, when I take a part of a movie and it's very usual scene, but as is not here, is in other works, I put in loop the fact that I put in loop this scene. This scene, it became the meaning change, and it's the same with my work. Sometimes. I take some situation and I change the context and it became another thing.
Yeah, then maybe just your use of these cinema moments, and also I think you're quite attached to literature also, because sometimes we hear those small phrases that are repeated in your videos. There is one whispering phrase here in this one. Maybe you could tell the audience a little bit about that.
About what?
How you use text and phrases that. Le texte, les phrases que tu utilises parfois, comme par exemple la citation de Rimbaud.
I use yes, la cita, Rimbaud, these poetic poems. I use because it is the end of the film de Jean-Luc Godard, Pierrot le Fou. It's the end, and and I repeat the end, and the film. Never finish. Is this I put in loop? Yes, I use poem, but for me, my inspiration, I repeat, is all the life. Sometimes I go to see a soccer play, soccer game. Sometimes, perhaps for me, it's more important. Is more important than to go to the Louvre. And perhaps when I go to the Louvre, I don't look at the canvas. I look only people shooting pictures. I don't know. I think the real life for me is more important than story called, than culture determinate things.
But it's also kind of a mixture of low and high culture that was very, I would say, kind of provocative in France when you started doing this.
No, I was not provocative. It was normal for me to make that.
Yes, it was normal for you, but I think some of the critics thought that you were quite provocative.
But I was was not provocative. Perhaps we ask if there are
yes,
some questions.
I think we should maybe ask the audience if you would like to ask some questions.
The many things I'm very interested in about the work, La Mer, is your use of sound and no sound, is the shift between sound and absolute silence. And perhaps, or I imagine that it has a relation to what you mentioned before, perhaps your interest or certain ties to perhaps an Eastern philosophical, experience, perhaps, or maybe it has to do with mine. As an audience, as someone who perceives this silence as perhaps the absolute most loud, sonically loud part of the work. I'm very interested in how you, and I would like to ask you to elaborate on how you, on this kind of, I perceive it as a kind of a magic of working very subtly but very thoroughly, exactly, with an absence and presence. Absence and presence.
Often, when all the time, then when I exhibit only the video of La Mer, not with other image, just when there is in a room La Mer, there is no sound. And some curator saw this work, and after they invite me to show this work. And when they receive the video, they say to me, oh, there is a problem, there is no sound. And I said to them, but the work, there is no sound. No, no, it's not true. I listen, I remember there was a sound. And like this idea to, in fact, people imagine a sound. And I think if I put the sound, we are too close of the reality. If I put the sound of the sea, I prefer for the sea that there are nothing. And for other image, yes, I use often music from my teenager age. When I was very young, the first song that I was listening was the first disc that I bought. And sometimes I work with friends with concrete music, with experimental friends that they work with sound. And I think the several images here and are did with them. And often also I use the sound of the Super 8 projector. And sometimes I ask to friends to work with the sound, or they modify it, but the base is the sound of the projector. And also, sometimes when a videotape is broken, it makes a noise, a white noise. And also, often I use this white noise as a base to build a music, not a music, a sound.
Any other questions? To yes.
Another thing that because I've been also, you know, what was the French word you used for digesting?
Ruminer.
I've been ruminating, I guess, the work for quite some time. So developing also questions and thoughts, of course. Another one that is really, because you mentioned the ISA, you mentioned the how the concept or concepts, plurally, of time are of essence and, are basically at the base as a subject for artists. And this very much happens in this work. And, thoughts about nostalgia versus memory versus repetitiveness. I'm curious of how you would verbalize yourself. You're using older, 20 or even older snippets from 60mm film. In your work and also your filmic scenes from family members, scenes that show yourself as a younger man and so on, to hear your thoughts about this in relation to the work itself.
Merci beaucoup. And I want to say thank you to Berta, to Aiza, to our build with me this project, and to the audience to come here. And you won't say.
I would like to just to hear some few words about your relationship with lights, because you say you work in, you know, video or cinema, and then objects, and there is one bridge between the two of work. For me, it's the light, and I would like to have some words about your relationship with the light. It can be the sun, it can be the light on the ceiling, or the projector, or the car. And if there is something you can say about the light,
I answer. I like the pure light. I like the only. The white of the light. I did this work also because we have the sea, we have the landscape, and between the sea and the landscape, we have this white wave. And this white wave is as the white page. Page, on dit comme ça. Hein? And or the white canvas before painting, and I like this space, this projection space, and is in this part that the artist investigates this light, this white, to build his work. And also, I don't answer exactly, but we change. Also, is a work about frontier. Frontier, the same.
Limits.
Yes, about limits. The limits between landscape and the sea, and is a natural limit. And this natural limit change every time, change if the weather is calm or if there is a big storm. And I like this idea of all change. And the light, I answer to your question, and the light put a focus all the time, the light of the sun, the light of a projector, put the focus on a scene and make you catch your eyes on this part where there is this light. For me, is very important.
Thank you. Second question, but quite different. It's more like about. I know that you've been teaching art a long time, and just a few words about your relationship with how do you teach art? Is it possible to teach art?
I was a very, very bad student, and for me it was very important to teach things that I don't know. I repeat, I don't know if perhaps you know the artist Philippe Parreno. He did this work with Zidane. You remember because we were in the same school. I bring Philippe. One of my teaching of Philippe Parreno, I was to bring him in a soccer stadium. And I think for him it was important because 10 years after, he did Zidane film. I think, I repeat that I say, my way to teach was to confront at the real life my student. Often I bring them, when I was invited, I bring them in the Documenta in 1997, I bring them a sculpture project in Kassel. Each time that it was possible for me to bring them to see a real art situation, it was very the best way to teach.
Well, thank you very much, Ange Leccia. I think if there are no more questions, I think this will be the end of our talk. And please stay and watch the video, and I think we will put the sound up as it's set usually, because actually for this talk we had to lower the sound quite a bit. Thank you very much.